Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me today on The King of Random. When I was a kid, I often dreamed of being a spy like James Bond or Jason Bourne. And an old-fashioned staple of the spy is being able to write secret messages from one person to another. There are a lot of different ways you can try and write secret messages, and the purpose of today's video is to try out three different types of invisible ink to see which ones work the best. The first type of invisible ink we'll try is lemon juice, which is invisible until you hold it over a heat source. The second is a mixture of baking soda and water, which is supposed to be revealed when you cover it in grape juice. The third experiment is to try and use bleach as an ink and see if it will show up under blacklight. Let's get started. For our first invisible ink test, we've got a couple of lemons. You could also buy the pre-squeezed lemon juice in bottles at the store. That should work just as well. Let's cut our lemon in half and squeeze the juice out onto this plate. I think that looks like enough juice to be used for a lot of ink. Now let's take a piece of a bamboo skewer or a toothpick, dip it in the juice, and try writing on our paper. Dip the bamboo skewer in the lemon juice so it has a little bit of a coating on it, and then use that as a stylus to write on a piece of paper. Let your lemon juice ink dry completely onto the paper. The lemon juice invisible ink is supposed to be activated by heat. You can use an incandescent light bulb, a lighter, or a stove to try and give some heat to your paper and bring out the secret message. First, I'm going to try this with a lighter. Of course, you need to be very careful that you don't light your piece of paper on fire. Keep the heat moving evenly to reduce your risk of flames. Ooh. There we go. You can clearly see the secret message. The flame did do a little bit of scorching on the paper in a couple of spots. So as I said, you have to be very careful or you could easily burn your secret message. That worked pretty well. I'm going to try a slight variation. I have here an old-fashioned fountain pen, and I'm going to try using the lemon juice as ink to write with this instead. Write our secret message. This time, instead of using the lighter, because it has such a high risk of lighting the paper on fire, I'm going to be using a glass-top stove. Using a glass-top stove gives us a nice, even surface to heat our paper over. That was supposed to be the letter U, and apparently I didn't have quite enough lemon juice on my pen. Our second method involves a mixture of baking soda and water as the ink, and grape juice to reveal it. I've mixed up about one part water and one part baking soda here. Not all of the baking soda will dissolve, but hopefully it will work just fine for our invisible ink. I'll try using my fancy pen again to see if this works. Let's use a little bit of paper towel to blot off the excess water. I've got two different methods I want to try to apply the grape juice. First, I'm going to use a little bit on a paper towel and rub it over the lettering. Next, I'm going to put some grape juice in this small spray bottle and spray it over what I've written. The lettering is a little bit visible, but it's not standing out a ton. Not bad. It's good as a juice. Let's see if it's good as a secret message revealer. Oh, that actually kind of worked. Sprayed it on, and I maybe sprayed on a little bit too much, but amazing. That wasn't too bad. It brought out the color. It's sort of a darker gray, maybe even a hint of blue in it. Maybe that's just from the juice. That works okay. I don't think it revealed as well as the lemon juice does, but it's kind of fun to be able to use a second chemical to make the first one appear. As an experiment, I'm also gonna see what happens if we use our baking soda water mixture as ink and then hold it over the heat the way we did with the lemon juice. Secret message starting to appear. Oh, what a good secret message. Actually, that turned out really well. That shows up very nicely. I think that's actually even darker than the lemon juice. Let's see what happens if we also put the heat over the one that had grape juice on it. That's cool. I don't know how well that showed on the camera, but all of the grape juice just turned like a lot more purple. And it started burning the paper, so that wasn't as good. For our third type of invisible ink, we're going to be using bleach and an ultraviolet flashlight. Ultraviolet is a frequency of light that we can't pick up very well with our eyes, but there are a lot of substances that will reflect it back in a frequency we can see. Ultraviolet lights are also known as black lights. So let's carefully pour out a small amount of our bleach and try writing with it to see what happens. First, let's see if the bleach itself seems to light up in the black light. Doesn't seem to be doing much, so I don't know how well this is going to work. Looks pretty much the same with the black light on it. Well, even though it's not lighting up very much on the plate, let's try it with our pen and paper. Okay, now in theory, the bleach is supposed to be reflective and sort of glow under the black light. Let's see how this works. Oh, it's the opposite of reflective. Where I've drawn with the bleach, the paper itself reflects the light pretty well. Where I've drawn the bleach, it completely stops reflecting. It's like black ink in the middle of the glowing white paper. That's cool. Weird, I would not have guessed that was gonna happen. I thought it was gonna glow. So that's interesting. The bleach seems to sort of stop the ultraviolet light from bouncing off of the paper. Strobe light. With this type of invisible ink, you can draw whatever you want, and one of the benefits of it is that it's not permanently visible. It only shows up when someone uses the black light on it. The lemon juice and the baking soda are both wonderful for sending concealed messages, but once they're revealed, it's permanently on the paper. If you use the black light and the bleach, it's only there when you've got the light on it. Something I like about using the bleach is that if you have a light of your own, you can see what you're putting on the paper as you write it. There you have it, three different methods of using invisible ink. Lemon juice, which shows up under heat, baking soda and water, which shows up a little bit with grape juice or also shows up with heat on it, and bleach, which I thought was gonna glow under a black light, but actually has the opposite effect. The paper around it glows and it stays nice and dark. I think my favorite of these is using the bleach because you can actually turn on your own black light and draw with it while you're looking at what you see. With the lemon juice or the baking soda ink, it's pretty hard to see what's going down on the paper because you can't heat it up and reveal it, or it's no longer a secret. Now you're all one step closer to becoming spies. This is a great activity for you to try at home, and it can be a fun way to send secret messages to your friends. Thank you for joining us for this experiment today, and we look forward to the next one. Talk to you then. I don't think it's gonna catch on as a breath spray.
Hey guys, thanks for supporting Nate so much in these videos. I know this used to be Grant Thompson, the King of Random, but for years there have been so many things that I've wanted to do for you that I just couldn't do by myself. But now that Nate's here helping out, I've got some room to breathe again, which means a lot of fun new things coming your way.